There are three things to prepare ahead of time prior to starting the hybridization. The first thing you prepare is the library that gets mixed with blockers. Those blockers are essentially there to help mask repetitive sequence throughout the genome to prevent any off-target binding from occurring. The second thing that needs to be prepared is the hybridization buffer. The XT workflow uses four components for the hybridization buffer, and these are mixed together ahead of time based in a table within the protocol. And then typically, I like to leave this hybridization buffer on a 37-degree heat block to prevent any precipitation from forming. Because if the hybridization buffer is left on the benchtop, there's a chance that the hybridization buffer will precipitate, and you'll get very poor capture performance if you use buffer that's precipitated. So by keeping your high buffer on the 37-degree heat block right up until you use it, you'll ensure that everything is in solution and ready to go for the hybridization. Now, the day or so before you actually perform the hybridization, a good thing to do is to perform a mock hybridization simply just by filling a 96-well PCR plate with water and then incubating that in your instrument for 24 hours at 65 degrees. After that 24-hour incubation, you can go in with a pipette throughout the different areas of the plate and measure the amount of volume that you've recovered. As long as you've recovered 20 or more microliters from the hybridization reaction, then you can consider that mock hybridization a success and can move forward using the actual reagents. So the first part of the hybridization involves preparing the library with the blockers that you've mixed together and putting that in the PCR plate. The PCR plate will then go onto our PCR instrument, and in this case, we're utilizing an Agilent 8800 SureCycler. That PCR plate will then be sealed and incubate at 95 degrees for 5 minutes. After the sample has denatured at 95 degrees for 5 minutes, the hybridization protocol will then take the block temperature down to 65 degrees. Once that 65 degree temperature has been held, you can then go in and perform the second part of the hybridization protocol, which is to warm and prepare our hybridization buffer. So the second step is to add the hybridization buffer that you've prepared to the PCR plate while it's still on the PCR instrument. So to do this, we'll quickly open the lid. We'll carefully peel back the seal to expose the row that is immediately above the sample where our capture library is. Transfer that volume of hybridization buffer, and then reseal the plate and close the lid. The hybridization buffer will then warm in the row directly above the library that we prepared for at least 5 minutes to make sure that it reaches that 65 degree temperature before we move on to the next step of the workflow. After the 5 minutes has elapsed, we're then going to perform the third step of the hybridization protocol and add our capture library, which is essentially our SureSelect baits mixed with a diluted RNase block, onto our PCR machine to also warm up to the 65 degrees that the block is being held at. Always make sure that your capture prior to being used for the hybridization is kept in an ice bucket to keep cool. So now that the hybridization buffer has been on the PCR machine and has come up to temperature for at least 5 minutes, we're now going to move on to the next part of the capture protocol, which is to add the capture library to the PCR machine as well to warm. Now, what I'll be doing is I'll be taking the capture library that's been pre-mixed with the RNase block solution, which has been kept in an ice bucket, and I'll be transferring that directly to the PCR plate into an independent row directly under the library that we prepared and put in the PCR plate initially. So now we're ready to add the capture baits to the PCR instrument. So what we're going to do is we're going to open up the PCR machine, and as you recall, in the middle row here is where the library that we prepared has been. In the row immediately above it is the row that contains the hybridization buffer, and we're going to be adding our capture baits to the row immediately below the library that we prepared. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to peel back the seal and only expose the row that I want to pipette my baits into. Transfer the baits directly into the bottom of the well. and then quickly reseal the plate using the same seal. We're now going to allow this to also come to temperature for an additional 2 minutes before we perform the final step of the hybridization protocol, which is to mix all of our components together. So now that the capture baits are ready, we're going to perform the mixing step of the hybridization protocol, where we combine the hybridization buffer with the capture baits, and then finally the library that we prepared with the hybridization buffer and capture baits pre-mixed together. This is essentially a two-step pipetting process and needs to be done efficiently to ensure that we're not suffering any kind of evaporation during this step of the protocol. So the first step is going to consist of transferring the hybridization buffer in the top row with the capture baits in the bottom row of the three-row block that we're working with in our PCR plate. So we'll remove the seal completely. And it's critical to maintain the plate while it's on the PCR machine and not take it off and look at it at all. So step one is going to be to transfer hybridization buffer in this top row with our capture library in this bottom row. We mix by pipetting up and down at least 5 times. So what we've done is we've transferred hybridization buffer from this row to this row. Now we're going to transfer the contents of the middle row to the bottom row. You'll then mix this thoroughly at least 8 to 10 times. And then upon completion of this mixing, you're going to carefully reseal the plate using a double PCR seal. So you want to be very quick and get your first seal tightly in place over the samples. As you can see, I've outlined the sample area that I was working in with brackets using a black marker just to help guide me. This is a nice trick. Again, I'm very tightly sealing these wells, rubbing my fingertip over each of the wells to ensure we have a very tight seal. And then I'm putting on a second layer of the film to really help ensure we're getting a very nice tight compression with the lid to avoid any evaporation from occurring. Now for this particular PCR instrument, the 8800 SureCycler, we actually recommend including a compression pad to go on top of the samples to add an additional layer of pressure onto the seals to ensure that we're not having any evaporation. Once the lid locks into place, the hybridization is complete and will go for 24 hours at 65 degrees.